In the last year, the New Kids on the Block have caused a sensation in the music world. These five Boston boys, with their boundless energy, enthusiasm, and infectious music, have sold out concert after concert and racked up sales of some 20 million records. I think my daughters are personally responsible for a good many of those sales. On Thursday, the group can be seen on a pay-per-view cable concert. The New Kids on the Block are with us, minus one of their members. From left to right, John joins us without his brother Jordan, who's a little under the weather, and Joseph McIntyre, Donnie Wahlberg, and Danny Wood are the other New Kids on the Block. How you guys doing?
Good.
The last time I saw you all was July.
Yes.
What, whatever this is, 7, 8 months it's been since that time. How's it going with all the adulation and the girls and the bodyguards and the people?
It's going.
It's going. That's going for sure. Yeah. How do you keep your heads on straight? Or do you do it to each other?
Yeah, we do it to each other. We all have a good grasp on each other's heads.
The big question everybody wants to know, are there rules concerning the girls you meet on tour as to how you deal with them or can go out with them or whatever?
No, I think it's really hard to, you know, to get into relationships now because we're so busy and stuff. I mean, we would like to have girlfriends and stuff like that, but as far as on the road, I mean, we really look at our fans more as, like, as friends. I mean, when we go out and when we walk through a hotel lobby and stuff and we see all our fans and stuff, we feel like a responsibility. I don't think it would feel right for any one of us to, you know, to try and, you know, date them or, you know, say, hey, what's your name? You know,
is he telling the truth?
It's true, because
you
like see someone in the crowd. I mean, if there's, like, 20 people and you, like, even want to, like, try to, like, point out a girl, you know, wave to her, the other girls are just, like, heartbroken, it seems. You know,
it would be very hard, too, to have a girlfriend back home when you're out there with all this going on.
Right.
She may not understand completely, right?
Yeah.
Do you all still live at home?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Everybody, I mean, when you can get there?
Yeah.
How long you got?
Everyone in America knows where we live.
Yeah? You're the only one that has to have a tutor, right?
Yeah.
How's that going? Are you getting your studies done?
Yeah.
Five months out on the road?
Sometimes it's tough because everyone's kind of out of school and you want to.
And you don't want to be doing. Do you make him do his work? Do you get on his case?
Joe is determined. I used to want someone to make me do my work. Joe is up. Joe, by the time we wake up in the morning, Joe's done school, gone to breakfast, gone out riding on his moped and come back 3 times already. So Joe's very motivated.
Very motivated.
I think his family really instill that in him. He has a great family.
Well, you got tons of brothers and sisters, right?
Yes.
How many?
Sisters and one brother.
How many? Say that again.
Trisha Cowell, Gene Kate, Tommy, and Joe.
That's 7, that's 8. Okay.
That's 9.
I couldn't keep up with you. We're going to break for just a minute. We'll come back and talk some more, all right?
Okay.
We'll be back with more of the New Kids on the Block right after this. With New Kids on the Block, and I found this in one of the magazines. You are the first act to have 6 top 10 singles in 1 year since Michael Jackson.
Yeah.
How do you guys account for it? I mean, it's written about all the time because it didn't catch on. The first album wasn't like a smash hit.
Mm-hmm.
It's something that happened this last year.
I think it just all came together. It had to do with a lot of it had to do with timing. Everyone has to have a right time, and I guess it was our time, so.
Is part of it also image, and it's an image that right now might be something that kids want? And that's
Well, I think it's just that I think people were ready for positivity, you know?
That's what I was really saying.
I mean, I'm not trying to down other groups and stuff for doing what they enjoy doing. I mean, you know, rock groups and groups that are a lot of times really stereotyped as being negative influences. Bands and other groups do what they want to do, but I think we're just came out being the positive people that we are, and I think America was just ready for it, and we're glad, you know, because it feels so good to see, you know, fans understanding our message and saying, you guys are really good, you know, for us, you taught us a lot of stuff. That's so flattering, and we're glad that people were ready for that message to come
and
across.
And it's interesting, too, because you guys are from Boston, but you didn't, like, grow up in a cloistered little environment. You were exposed to all this stuff, and yet somehow you were able to, you know, shun it and go out there and carry the message.
Yeah, that word.
Yeah, our growing up in Boston really probably is what made us what we are today. You know, we grew up in an environment where, you know, we were exposed to all different types of people at such a young age that we really weren't, we didn't have any reservations about people. You know, we weren't, it wasn't like, you know, a lot of times when you grow up in an enclosed environment, you become ignorant about everything that's outside of your environment. And when it's time for you to go out into the world and deal with different people and stuff that you've never been around, it's really hard for you to deal with. You know, you kind of close up and you don't know what to do.
And it would be really hard for you since you were like thrown out there. And now, besides the group here, there's going to be a new Saturday morning children's animated New Kids on the Block.
That's exciting. We just recently got to see the scripts, and I know when I was reading the scripts, I was laughing. I think it's going to be, you know, it's going to be a real good cartoon. We're very happy with it.
It's still not determined whether you'll do the voices or not, some of them at least?
Well, I think they're going to have a one-hour special, like on prime time at night, to kick it off. And I think that we'll do the voices for that, but then it's going to be kind of hard doing the voices for the rest of it while we're on the road. I don't know if we'll
be able
to do it.
We can only split you guys up so much. You can only do so much.
I mean, we really want to do the voices, and I think we're going to do our best to do as many of them as possible.
And maybe a movie, I hear.
Yeah. I know our manager was just out in L.A. A couple days ago, still, you know, working out the deals and stuff.
And you're recording, is it true that you guys record on the road in your hotel rooms?
Yeah.
Or maybe I should say hotel bathrooms,
yeah,
I hear?
We did the Christmas album in a hotel room, and so that was a great success. And we did the upcoming album, so.
After 5 months on the road, are you going to kind of be glad to be back home?
Yeah.
Is it going to be possible to go back home, though, and just kind of hang out and go down to the, you know,
go
to the movies?
My friends,
last time we went home for 2 days, they were saying over the radio that my brother was at a donut store downtown.
I know.
So, like, even when we're not coming home, people still find out. Like, if we just sneak in, people just somehow find out, and the word gets out, and then there's like 30 cars parked out in front of our house.
But it's worth it. I know that you're traveling with all the bodyguards.
I like it. I don't care when they come to my house. I think it's
a little birdie told me that you are the one in the group who also likes older women. Wait, if you want to rat on them, go ahead.
Who said that?
Huh?
I like my mother. I like you.
Well, they are more than your everyday pop stars. They are. It's really amazing. They're sort of a social and economic phenomenon. Not only does the group sell millions of records, but their name is expected to move several $100 million worth of merchandise this year. Most of the t-shirts, I think, are right in my own neighborhood.
Yes.
In a few moments, we're going to learn how the kids keep their heads together in the midst of all this. And not surprisingly, I suppose.
Good Morning America continues.
Excuse me, just is also part of the mix. Part two.